Welcome back, everyone, for another episode of Lulu's Perch. In this episode, Geoff Lawton is going to teach us how he creates compost and builds soil in the desert with the help of some unexpected workers. Let's check it out. Now, the problem at the moment is that farmers all over the world are burning off valuable piles of old crops and vegetation when they could be salvaging these resources, saving money, and protecting the environment by creating compost. Now, growing food by the Dead Sea may seem like an impossible task, especially when the land is so salty that they name cities after it. But with the right combination of ingredients and a few helpers, you can create compost and grow food anywhere. Yeah, okay, but what on earth is compost? Well, compost is decomposed organic matter. It's that soft, fluffy soil you'd find on a healthy forest floor, or in the gutters on your roof. Interesting. So, how does it benefit my garden? Ah, I'm glad you asked. You see, a finished compost heap contains rich minerals and trace elements, billions of beneficial microbial life forms, kilometers of mycelium fungus strands, and liters upon liters of extra water retention, which all work together to help our plants grow. Yeah, cool. So how do we make it? Well, before we make it, we need to collect four main ingredients. Number one being our brown dead material. This is our carbon. Number two, our green living material. This is our nitrogen. Number three, our water. And number four, oxygen. Now that we have our four main ingredients, we can begin by starting with a brown carbon layer of material. Secondly, we can move on to our green living nitrogen layer, and then we rinse it with water and we repeat. Now, you can't just go layering any amounts of brown and green material. If you put too much green in there, it's gonna get stanky and really hot and anaerobic, and no microbial life is gonna survive in there. On the other hand, if you put too much carbon in there, there's not gonna be enough chemical reaction and the whole pile's gonna go cold. But thankfully, there's a decomposition ratio which will increase the chances that your compost will be successful. And that ratio is 9 buckets of brown material, your carbon, 6 buckets of green material, your nitrogen, and, optional, 3 buckets of animal manure. Sounds a little bit complicated, but how am I going to know if it's working? Alright, so we're going to get a little bit sciencey here.
Yes, science!
We want all of our tiny microbes and squirmy worms to be rugged up in their little beds at a temperature between 55 and 65 degrees Celsius. You can test your pile without all the science equipment and thermometers. You just gotta use your hands like they do in Jurassic Park.
That is one big pile of shit.
Now it's your turn. Stick your hands into that pile, and if it's too hot to hold for longer than a second, it means it's too hot for any microbial life to survive. You need to add carbon and flip it. If the middle of the pile is too cold, add some green material and flip it. Now take a chunk of compost in your hand and squeeze it. If water pours out of it, add some brown and green material, but no water. The pile's saturated. If no water comes out at all, hose it down, walk away. Easy. And finally, the sniff test. If your compost pile stinks, it means you've got too much nitrogen in there. You need to add carbon and flip it.
Why are we doing the flipping thing? Ah, remember the fourth and final ingredient, oxygen. Adding oxygen to the compost pile encourages aerobic microbes to decompose the pile much faster, as opposed to anaerobic bacteria, which take much longer and they stink. Oh, geez. How often do I have to flip this? Well, dear friend, how quickly do you want your soil? If you need it quick, the record so far is 18 days using the Berkeley method. This is where you build a pile, leave it for 4 days to heat up, and then flip it every second day thereafter. On the 18th day, it should be ready. Or, on the other hand, you can use Geoff Lawton's secret workers to flip it. Chickens.
Chicken tractor on steroids, producing potentially one of those compost piles every week, is definitely something that can drive this project forward. And now we've linked it very precisely with the rabbits, and the connection to the rabbits gives us a manure harvest straight through from rabbits to chickens to compost, and it's more than proven itself.
In Geoff's chicken tractor design, he uses leftover green nitrogen material to feed the rabbits, who strip the leaves and bark off it until it becomes brown carbon material. We then sweep the carbon out and down into the chickens next door, who cover it in their manure. From here, it's swept down into the compost area and stacked using the compost ratio. The chickens then flip the pile and we keep restacking it until it's a finished pile at the bottom exit gate and ready to use for planting. Well, there you have it, guys. We just made compost in the desert with chickens and rabbits. You're not a rabbit. Next episode, I'm gonna be taking cover from automatic gunfire. I'm gonna go to the Dead Sea for rest and relaxation. Two extremes, one episode. It's gonna be wild. Try get outside, cook some compost for the chickens. I'll see you in the next chapter. Catch ya.